Hey guys, welcome to online sessions of Great Tutorial. In the last session, we have started with entrepreneurship development, and today we are going to discuss the same topic, recent development in entrepreneurship development. Today's topic is agrotourism and Stand Up India scheme for women enterprise. So let's see what is agrotourism. In an increasingly mechanized world, many people have lost touch with how their food is produced or the region where it is originated. Agrotourism offers tourists a chance to reconnect with the land and provide a hands-on experience with local food. Agrotourism activities include picking fruits, tending bees, milking cow, and other educational pursuits. So now in this fast, you can say, urban city life, we all have completely lost touch with our rural India. We don't have any connection with the nature. So the basic idea behind agrotourism is to offer a chance to people to reconnect with the land and provide a hands-on experiences so that people can get into touch with the nature, with the you can say that people can go back to nature and they will get to know that the personal, they will get to know and they will have a very personal experiences of hands-on experiences with the local food and how the food is produced or the region where it is originated. Agrotourism focuses on travel that is empowering to local communities, both socially and economically. Recognizing the need to diversify their farm product and supplement their agriculture, many farmers consider agrotourism as a one income option for long-term sustainability of their farm. Agrotourism can support agricultural economy when local producer can no longer compete economically. See, now agrotourism focuses on travel that is empowering to local communities, both socially and economically. Recognizing the need to diversify their farm products. See, farmers who are not able to generate sufficient income with their farming activities. So they have realized that agrotourism is an option. It is a scope, it is a chance where they can generate extra income or they can have it as a main source of income, where they can attract tourists by giving them good experiences. They can attract tourists, and which is going to support agricultural economy. And with that, they can generate extra income. Now, let's see the definition of agrotourism. Agrotourism is the idea of bringing back urban resident to rural area for leisure, travel, and spending. See, agrotourism is the idea. Idea kya hai? Is the idea of bringing urban population to rural area for leisure, travel, and spending. See, agritourism is a source of income for them, for farmers, for the people who are involved in this activity. But to the other rural population, to the urban population, the people, they get a chance, they get a needed break from their day-to-day life, and they can connect with the nature because of this. So agrotourism is a commercial enterprise at a working farm, ranch, or agricultural plant conducted for enjoyment of visitor that generate supplement income for the owner. Agrotourism kya hai? Agrotourism ek tarah ka enterprise hai. It is a kind of plant which is conducted. Conducted for the enjoyment of visitor. जो विजिटर वहां पे आए, जो टूरिस्ट वहां पे आए, उनके एंजॉयमेंट के लिए दैट जनरेट सप्लीमेंट इनकम फॉर द ओनर, एंड इट इज ऑल्सो चांस फॉर ओनर टू अर्न, टू जनरेट एक्स्ट्रा इनकम. इन शॉर्ट वी कैन से दैट एग्रो टूरिज्म ऑफर टूरिस्ट अ चांस टू रिकनेक्ट विद द लैंड एंड प्रोवाइड अ हैंड ऑन एक्सपीरियंस विद लोकल फूड. एग्रो टूरिज्म एक तरह का अपॉर्चुनिटी है फॉर द पीपल हु आर इन अर्बन एरियाज, फॉर द पीपल लाइक अस टू गेट कनेक्टेड विद द लैंड, विद द नेचर एंड हैव अ गुड एक्सपीरियंसेस विद द लोकल फूड. नाउ लेट्स have a look at the activities in the agro-tourism. Agro-tourism, agri-tourism and natural tourism enterprises might include. See the agri-tourism and nature tourism enterprises which are conducted. These are the activities they are including in it. First one is outdoor recreation. Here people can enjoy trekking, fishing. Here people will get a chance to trek, get a chance to fish, hunting, wildlife study, horseback riding, they can go for tracking. Next is educational experiences, which is good for students. Here they will have farming experiences like rice plantation, cooking experience on chula. The next is entertainment. Harvest festival like Hoda party in Maharashtra, they will also get a chance to attend a kind of festival which will be having their local, which will we can say that which will be having a local traditional touch. Next is hospitality service, farm stay, guided tours or outfitter services. Next is on farm direct sale, UP cooperation on roadside stand. Happy customer will definitely return. They believe that if the customer is happy and with their service, they definitely they are going to return. They will also recommend the same thing to their friends and family. Farmer can add value to your guest experience by offering them refreshment. Farmers, they also provide extra services by offering refreshment and other things. They can select product that complement with what they produce on farm, such as milk or butter sample, fresh fruit juice, etc. With time and creativity, farmer can expand their recreation enterprise through fun entertainment activities such as contest, adult and child classes or games. Children love straw mazes, pumpkin painting and scarecrow making. Adult may enjoy historical display or classes on painting. So here we can see that all activity they have considered in their mind, like they have, it is a kind of full package. They have given importance to everything. They have included everything: fun element, educational experiences, entertainment, hospitality, on-farm direct sale. People can go and directly they can pick fruits, they can pick things from the farm directly, hand-picked fruits they can get. So here they have given, like they have given a full package kind of services. So basically we can say that agro-tourism is an activity where they are giving an opportunity to people of urban area, of cities, to get a chance to reconnect with the with our nature, with our rural India. See, now the next is Stand Up India scheme for financing SC, ST and or women entrepreneur. Stand Up India scheme. Objectives of Stand Up India scheme. The objective of Stand Up India scheme is to facilitate bank loan between 10 lakh and rupees 1 crore to at least one scheduled caste or scheduled tribe borrower and at least one woman borrower per bank branch for setting up greenfield enterprise. This enterprise may be in manufacturing, services or the trading sector. In case of non-individual enterprise, at least 51% of shareholding and controlling stake should be held by either an SC, ST or a woman entrepreneur. See, basically Stand Up India scheme is to facilitate bank loan between 10 lakh and rupees 1 crore, at least it is a kind of facility which is given to the people of SC, ST borrower and at least one woman borrower per bank branch for setting up a greenfield enterprise. See, this kind of bank, at least they will give loan they will provide loan to one scheduled caste tribe, scheduled caste person, one scheduled tribe person, and at least one woman enterprise, a woman borrower, to set up her greenfield enterprise. So that woman entrepreneur, I want to say, so that she can set up a greenfield enterprise. The enterprise, the greenfield enterprise, may be in manufacturing service. See, the enterprise for which the loan has been offered, for which the scheme is made, the enterprise, it include manufacturing services or trading sector. See, now if the scene is that it is a non-individual enterprise, many people are involved, many shareholders are involved, so they will get the benefit of the scheme only in the situation when the 51% of the shareholding and controlling stake should be with either an SC, ST or woman entrepreneur. See, when a company is non-individual enterprise, it means that many people are involved. Like they are collecting funds from general public. So in that case also, this scheme will only benefit. This scheme will only benefit if the majority stock, the majority stake, 51% shareholdings, majority stake should be held by either an SC, ST or a woman entrepreneur. So we can see that the Stand Up India scheme is for helping financially to the people of scheduled caste, scheduled tribe and women entrepreneur. अभी अगर ऐसा situation है कि वो company non-individual enterprise है, non-individual means it does not belong to single person, वो उसमें बहुत सारे shareholders involved है, पैसा जो है वो general public से raise किया गया है, तो in that case this scheme will benefit. In that case, you will be benefited only when the 51% of shareholdings and controlling stake is with either an SC, ST person or woman entrepreneur. We can see that Stand Up India scheme is basically for the people who are of SC caste, SC, ST or a woman entrepreneur. They will get benefit of this scheme. Now next is, we will see eligibility. What is the eligibility if you want to get benefit? If you want to get benefited with this scheme, then what is the eligibility criteria? First one is SC, ST or woman entrepreneur above 18 years of age. You will get benefit of this scheme only if you are SC, ST or woman entrepreneur and your age should, you should be above 18 years of age. Next, loan under the scheme are available for only greenfield project. Greenfield signify the first time venture of the beneficiary in manufacturing, service or trading sector. See, this scheme will be applicable only if you are involved in manufacturing, service or trading sector, and that too the first time venture of beneficiary. If it is your first time project and that too in manufacturing, service sector or trading sector, in that case only you will be beneficial, you can get benefit of the scheme. Next is, in case of non-individual enterprise, see, हमने पहले भी देखा है, in case of non-individual enterprise, अगर आपने पैसा जो है वो पैसा फंड किया है जनरल पब्लिक से, इन दैट केस 51% ऑफ शेयर होल्डिंग एंड कंट्रोलिंग स्टेक शुड बी हेल्ड बाय इधर एससी, एसटी और अ वुमेन एंटरप्रेन्योर. आपको बेनिफिट, इस स्कीम का बेनिफिट तभी मिलेगा जब आपका 51% जो शेयर होल्डिंग है वो किसी एससी पर्सन के पास है, एसटी के पास है या फिर कोई वुमेन एंटरप्रेन्योर है, तभी आप को ये स्कीम का जो है वो बेनिफिट मिले. नेचर ऑफ लोन, कंपोजिट लोन इंक्लूसिव ऑफ टर्म लोन एंड वर्किंग कैपिटल बिटवीन 10 लाख एंड अप टू 1 करोड़ लाख. सी, ये आपको कंपोजिट लोन मिलेगा जिसका जो टर्म लोन मींस एक पर्टिकुलर टर्म टाइम पीरियड के लिए होता है, एंड वर्किंग कैपिटल के लिए भी आपको फंड्स मिलता है, एंड इट विल बी बिटवीन 10 लाख एंड अप टू 1 करोड़ नेक्स्ट. नेक्स्ट इज पर्पस ऑफ लोन. ये हमने पहले भी देखा है. द मेन पर्पस ऑफ दिस स्कीम इज द पर्सन इज दैट द मेन पर्पस इज सेटिंग अप अ न्यू एंटरप्राइज इन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ट्रेडिंग और सर्विस सेक्टर बाय एससी एसटी और वुमेन एंटरप्रेन्योर. इफ इट इज योर फर्स्ट टाइम वेंचर इन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ट्रेडिंग और सर्विसेज एंड इफ यू बिलोंग टू एससी एसटी और यू आर एन वुमेन एंटरप्रेन्योर देन यू विल गेट दिस लोन. नेक्स्ट इज साइज ऑफ लोन. कंपोजिट लोन ऑफ 75% ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट कॉस्ट इंक्लूसिंग ऑफ टर्म लोन एंड वर्किंग कैपिटल. हाउएवर इट विल नॉट बी एप्लीकेबल इफ द बोरोवर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट अलॉन्ग विथ कर्विजन एंड सपोर्ट फ्रॉम एनी अदर स्कीम एक्सीड 25% ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट कॉस्ट. सी यू विल गेट कंपोजिट लोन ऑफ 75% ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट कॉस्ट इन दिस टर्म लोन एंड वर्किंग कैपिटल इंक्लूसिव ऑफ टर्म लोन. आपको टर्म इसमें टर्म लोन एंड वर्किंग कैपिटल मिलेगा आपको. हाउएवर द स्कीम इज नॉट एप्लीकेबल इफ यू आर गेटिंग अ सपोर्ट इफ यू हैव टेकन अप सम अदर स्कीम विच एक्सीड 25% ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट कॉस्ट. नेक्स्ट इज इंटरेस्ट रेट. द रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट वुड बी लोवेस्ट एप्लीकेबल रेट ऑफ द बैंक फॉर दैट कैटेगरी. सी यहाँ पे जो आपको इंटरेस्ट रेट मिलेगा वो बहुत कम, उस बैंक का सबसे जो कम एप्लीकेबल इंटरेस्ट रेट है वो यहाँ पे मिलेगा. नेक्स्ट है सिक्योरिटी. सी बिसाइड प्राइमरी सिक्योरिटी द लोन में बी सिक्योर्ड बाय कोलैटरल सिक्योरिटी और गारंटी ऑफ CGFSIL. नेक्स्ट इज रीपेमेंट. द लोन इज रीपेबल इन 7 ईयर विद अ मैक्सिमम मोरेटोरियम पीरियड ऑफ 18 मंथ. सी ये जो लोन है ये आपको 7 ईयर्स में आपको रीपेबल है एंड विद मैक्सिमम मोनिटर में तो अब जो आपको एक्सटेंडेड 18 मंथ का पीरियड भी मिलेगा. सो बेसिकली दिस स्टैंडअप इंडिया स्कीम इज टू सपोर्ट पीपल ऑफ एससी एसटी एंड अ वुमेन एंटरप्रेन्योर. इफ यू आर वेंचरिंग इट फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, अगर आप फर्स्ट टाइम, अगर आपका फर्स्ट प्रोजेक्ट है एंड it is of manufacturing, it is in manufacturing services or trading sector, you will get benefit of this Stand Up India scheme. So with this we have completed with Stand Up India scheme. Now here we have studied two schemes. First one is agro tourism, which is a new approach toward entrepreneurship. Here this agro tourism offered tourists a chance to reconnect with the land and provide a hands-on experiences with local food, and they even they get a chance to get extra income with this activity. Now the second one is Stand Up India scheme for financing SC/ST or women entrepreneur, जो अभी हमने डिटेल में डिस्कस किया है. स्टैंड अप इंडिया स्कीम इज बेसिकली इट इज फॉर एससी एसटी. इट इज टू सपोर्ट एससी एसटी and a woman entrepreneur so that they can start they can start up their own venture, and this scheme will benefit only if it is for the first time venture, if it is the first project of a person who belongs to SC, NT or a woman enterprise. So I guess the things are very very clear to you all, and with this I end my session. Thank you so very much.